Hey, this is for everybody who has already met their karmic soulmate, twin flame soulmate. And for those of you who are still thinking, who is he? Who is she? Where can I find them? So before I start, I'm going to just explain to you the spread that I have developed for this occasion. So here are the significators that I'm using for this particular reading. Remember, significators mean that this is going to be the same for every sign. The reason why I'm choosing them, it's sort of like the category that I really want to find the answers to, as if you're in a bookstore and you find a book with this title. So let me explain to you the significators that I'm choosing. The first one is Luna. Luna is going to tell me about the darkness and everything that maybe still didn't surface, maybe things that you don't know, maybe things that you should know. Then we have Solar Deity. Solar Deity is going to tell us what you should know. Maybe there is like still somewhere lingering, maybe it is too bright for you, maybe it's too close to your eyes, but you're going to realize that maybe you know that. Then we have reason. Many of us are asking, why? That's the hardest question as a therapist and as a reader to really answer, why? Because we people don't really make too much sense when it comes to love. So we're going to try to answer it within this card. Then we have the card guidance. Let's see, because it's your mirror soul, what do you need to find out about this person? If you guys still didn't read my introduction to this series, please check somewhere in this corner before you proceed, because it's going to tell you really how and what I see it. I see it as a mirror, and that's why this is called Mirror Healing Series. Then we are getting to the Tower, and the Tower is going to tell us about what needs to break. It is like always a time that certain things cannot grow anymore. And maybe they cannot grow because they're not sustainable. Maybe, you know, we need to kind of change us. Maybe they need to change. Whatever it is, we're going to discover it in this category. And the Chariot, a lovely card with pushing it forward. Where do we go? Which turn do we take? And then let's check the significance of all of this. Two of Chalices. Is there a kiss that is going to happen? Or what at this point of time is karma telling us? So, guys, shall we start? Welcome to your Karmic Soulmate Twin Flame reading for July 2018. So let's start. So what is still unknown? What is like going behind the scenes that you still will rediscover? Prince of Cups and Six of Swords and Courtship, but it was reversed. Now, Prince and Cups in this particular deck is the King. So, it is kind of like really interesting because I'm seeing Caduceus snakes over here, the healing, and I'm seeing the snake of wisdom over here. So, it could be, as you see, it's Scorpionic male. It could be that Scorpio energy that is coming through. So there is something in the background over here. Maybe some kind of dating, maybe courtship. But Six of Swords is it definitely, because look at this, he's defining his own space over here. It's kind of like really interesting because it looks like the truth is elsewhere. It's almost if he's pointing one way, but he's still looking back. Is there somebody that you have dated? Maybe, like, you know, you're not dating anymore, maybe, you know, you are sort of like in that transition. Six of Swords is always a transition card, but being a six is also a lover's card. And like, I mean, this is adding to 10. It is kind of like moving forward energy, but like this, you're still not fully able to move forward. There is like a fine balancing that needs to take place, because look, even though he's able to maintain his position, he kind of like knows that he has to stop looking back and has to kind of like move forward, because he's pointing at his healing, and the healing is not in this person. The healing is not in something that has happened. So this is kind of like really interesting that you're having, you see, because this is kind of like very kind of, I guess, mystical deck. Snakes are definitely talking about healing, about the Kundalini, and Kundalini is basically represented with the snake, coiled snake at our base chakra, at the bottom of the spine, which needs to activate. And looks like he is doing that. He's kind of activating, and those snakes are starting to swirl around your chakra points over here. So something that is like really still hidden from you is maybe something happening with somebody. Maybe somebody is moving on. Maybe you are still observing some kind of situation, or simply just still can tell me that there is complete lack of clarity about a person who you looks like dated, who you really wanted very much, but things really, really got hard. So let's see, solar deity, sort of like your card is like that clarity. You see, this is the difference between it. You guys need clarity in your situation. You guys need clarity in your life. This is like what this card is representing. There is like this like huge, enormous energy of rebirth. So let's see what is known to you. So Queen of Cups and Ten of Pentacles. So whether this is you or there is somebody else, like, what is the next one? Sudden wealth. It is a couple over here that it is kind of like really interesting, because there is like this loving queen and both Prince of Cups and Queen of Cups, and they actually form a pair. And Ten of Pentacles is like this family, and there is like sudden wealth, but this is a kind of gambling. So whether this is you, that can mean two things. Whether, one, you are reuniting with your twin flame, somebody is really coming to you, and there is like this whole sense of family merging, coming together, somebody kind of like bringing the generational process. But then, why is this card coming out here? Because it's again the card of healing that you're just having here. Maybe you are trying to heal some situation where you were part of the family, where at least you had that vision, because here Six of Swords is like really leaving behind. You know, like, I mean, when you're ready to go to the university and sort of like you're anticipating what's going to happen, but you're also kind of like taken aback with everything that is going on. So I don't know if this is you guys, because Queen of Cups is definitely not your energy. You are like, go, go, go. I just want to do stuff. I kind of like want to kind of chase stuff. And almost like this represents your dreams. So there is like something connecting to the family, but something that is becoming a really big gamble, or something that maybe is just like not sustainable, because sudden wealth means maybe somebody's going to come to light very suddenly, and you might take it to heart more than you should, or don't take it to heart more than you should. Definitely, I'm seeing here that it could be a possibility of some kind of travel as well, because Six of Swords definitely talks about travel. This is the energy also, like whenever I see this healing energy, and keep in mind we are in the year number 11, and if you haven't checked my annual scopes, check them in the description box, they're all there. Also check my kind of like definition of this kind of like twin flames. This is like a mirror image, facing ourselves, having maybe simultaneous things that are working or not working, sometimes apparently different, but they're still the same. It's kind of like very very kind of symptomatic of this type of relationships. So I don't know, I kind of like feel you're really willing and ready to have this kind of like relationship, but at the same time, something sudden wealth, you know, sudden wealth is not necessarily good news. it is a good news if it's shared, but what if one person wants everything for themselves? And kind of like, given that the courtship came here reversed, it's kind of like almost like feeling that this is not you. It's almost kind of feeling that maybe something happened to somebody else, and there is like this sense of shock and a sense of kind of like feeling blindsided in the situation. So let me see the reasons for that. And there you are. Eight of Cups, Queen of Wands, and imprisonment. But it's reversed. You guys are getting a get out of jail card. This is like a walking away. You're getting free. You did unlock it. They're like no naggings. They're not little small things. There's no sense of feeling, you know, trapped anymore. The Eight of Cups is that essence of the card saying, is this the best for me? Is this really the best that I can amount to? Because look, she has, and it's kind of like really interesting over here. We see, like I have to take it closer to you. We see an archer over here in the background. Is this going to, you see it here on the top? Somebody ready to defend, and there is like this tower, but this tower is solid. It is like really solidly built, and she knows that somebody is watching her back, and she knows, right, that she can claim her stuff. This is you guys, Queen of Wands. This is you. It is like all about, and that's the reason. This was all about you. The entire situation was your learning exercise. That you need to kind of, you're Leo after all. You need to have that majestic roar, like roar, right? And somebody maybe kind of like took this away from you. And no, you're not made to into being a little kitten and pussycat. You're a big majestic lion. And even though maybe something looked very appealing at the time, this is not the situation where you can keep the crown on. And it's telling you clearly, like both of these cards, this card is saying you need to find out something that is emotionally fulfilling for you. Because even though you're all saddened, and doesn't he look like John Travolta? So maybe some of you kind of like going on that kind of level. But somebody's here, look at this, everything is dead, everything is broken, almost like it's possibly even giving me a long distance, a trip somewhere where I see a coastal region for some kind of reason. But like imprisonment reversed is like kind of getting out of the jail card. Like now you have to unlock, you are unlocking certain things in you. This whole energy, the whole situation happened so you can actually kind of like really learn about yourselves. This is the long, lifelong process that we actually have to learn who we are and where we are going and what we really want to do in this situation. So what is the guidance for you guys in this situation? Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh, I'm getting goosebumps. This is really lovely. A house. But you also have Ace of Pentacles and the Sun. But the house came reversed. Which is kind of interesting, because to me, these are like, this is a lovely situation. It is a new beginning. Maybe whatever the house is, heart is where the home is. This house not necessarily is not any of our houses. Like, I mean, this is obviously something very affluent, and maybe it's a dream house. Maybe it's a time to kind of like step out of your dreams, because this is like this card of, you know, leaving the past in the past. Maybe this was like sort of proverbial fairy tale house, which now it is a time to get more pragmatic, more kind of like moving, more seeing what do I want to do. These are long-term plants. You're planting long-term seeds, and seeds are great, but they don't always kind of bear fruit. But in your case, the seeds that you'll be planting will bear fruit, because you're getting your own card here, the Sun. And the Sun is talking about, again, just like the Queen of Wands, you guys are shining again. You guys are sort of like coming off this pedestal. It's one thing is like having somebody having your back and you being majestic. Another thing is like being majestic and looking the lay of land and feeling very comfortable about that. This is the card of new kind of like conquers, of marriages, of celebrations. So your guidance
is that something is ahead of you, that you are actually learning some kind of lesson. It's kind of like, looks like you're leaving a situation behind. Maybe to some extent in the beginning, you're still going to be stuck in that energy. But this is clearly the energy that is going to free you, that is going to make you feel being who you are, like loving who you are. The sun energy is extremely, extremely important. And it's kind of like, you know what? It is like time. It is time for you to be in love with you, right? Your entire sign is about generosity. Your entire sign is about having this very kind of like deep strength and fortitude, but not really ruling with kind of like war, ruling with gentleness, ruling with love. This is kind of like what it is. So let me see what, and this card really wanted to slide down, so I'm really interested to see what that's going to be. And we have Princess of Pentacles, a Three of Pentacles. And the card that I'm wanting to come down is Nine of Swords. It kind of does make sense. And we have the message. So some message is not received, or if the message is received, it's going to be something that is really pierced. This is definitely good. You're going down into pentacles. Like your energy is a little bit higher than earth energy, but like you're grounding. So what needs to be done again? What needs to be done is like really high energy. Like there is like still a mix. Maybe certain things have not been for you. The Princess of Pentacles, the Three of Pentacles are talking about learning a new skill or learning something about somebody that is not sustainable. These are good cards, but in this category, what is not sustainable is that certain things were not part of the teamwork anymore, and certain things were collapsing. And certain things were collapsing because somebody was immature. You have been receiving either, you know, like sometimes no message is a message in itself, and this is definitely giving me this kind of like thing, because look at that. In this kind of card, it's kind of like the sword is actually tearing him through. It's kind of like the feeling of, and she has this third eye over here, so you have not followed yourself. And as a result of that, there were like lots of things. Or maybe you still have to go through the phase of relating certain message. But look, you have a tower here, repetition. There is like this collapse over here, that certain things are just simply not sustainable anymore. Everything is like sort of falling apart. Like you see this house, everything. And however, and the snake is being torn here as well. So I don't know who is the snake in this particular scenario over here. Maybe there will be messages. I don't know, guys. This kind of like does look like there was somebody else who have been missing, because two queen and one king. One queen is too much. So who is this Queen of Cups? Maybe somebody put like seductive charms, and you need to kind of like re-establish yourself. But there is a clear sense of still being in the past. But the good news is like, even though moving forward is going to be hard, it's still kind of like moving forward. It's still kind of like working this energy. Maybe you're going to receive the message that is going to upset you. Maybe you're going to see something that will upset you. Maybe finally there's going to be a shocking realization that certain thing you kind of like, it's a very difficult for you to see, like something revolving just before your eyes, because the messages can be anything. It can be the direct message. It doesn't have to be direct message. It could be like through the grapevine. Could be simply your messages that you get, this universal message, right? So Tower is a message of that kind. It's something kind of like comes as a shock. So let me just see here what is the best point forward in this particular situation. So you have Five of Wands, you have the Hangman, and then you have Toil and Labor. I think I almost had similar situation with the previous two readings, but not exactly in this. Again, you have like this healing energy, 38 is 11. This keeps repeating. 7-11. Are you guys like your entire waking hours having this kind of feeling that maybe you're programmed? Are you really trying to sort of like get out of certain kind of like stuck energy. It really feels this way to me, because the reasons here are that you need to claim yourself. So almost like somebody took your special powers away. Somebody put you in the cage, and like there is like this caged energy, but like right now you have found the lock to that cage. And you know, almost looks like a Stockholm syndrome to me, that some of you are trying to perpetuate the situation that's clearly not good for you. In Stockholm syndrome, you have a victim who is clearly a victim, somebody who is tortured. But you know, the best, that's a horrible choice of words. Usually the torturer is the most effective when you convince the victim that actually they want to be in that situation. Right? So sort of like you indoctrinate them. So in Stockholm syndrome, the victim actually falls in love with their perpetrator. So you have many of those basically victims of rape that are sort of like so messed up that they actually think this person was in love with them, because here and there they did tell them something that would indicate that, and so hence they kind of like willingly stayed in a situation. And I think this is like what you're debating. The Chariot is saying that you have to go through some kind of like phase where you kind of like have to figure out what are your boundaries, in which direction you want to go. Because look at this, guys, it's kind of escaping, almost like somebody is coming on to you and you're saying, no. But at the same time, there is like this hangman, and in this deck, the hangman is like not tight, you see, he's like willingly hanging, and he actually is putting his hands in prayer. There is like this lots of thinking energy, so it's the sun that is setting. It's kind of like understanding of what is going on, what is happening. And I really think this is like something that you really needed to know. You kind of like need to figure out what you are sacrificing and why you're sacrificing in a situation. It is also kind of like good to look situation from a different angle and sort of like see all aspects of what has happened or how it happened, because it looks to me that you still don't have the whole truth, and this is kind of like really, really bothering you in this situation. So let me just see about the direction of this twin flame union at this time. Judgment and Princess of Cups. Where did they have this? I had it somewhere here. This house had a similar kind of like vibe as the Judgment. And Distant Horizons. I don't know. Is there somebody who is long distance? Are you going some kind of trip? Judgment is also Scorpionic energy. So you're getting a lots of like this rebirth. You know, Scorpio kind of like, when it feels cornered, it kind of like kills itself, because it just doesn't prefers that kind of complete destruction than being trapped. But here in this Judgment energy, it's like kind of like breaking that ceiling. Like, looks like you have been boxed in, and now there is like a time. There is like your twin flame and you, when this card comes, and when this card comes, there was like a thing. You have been married with this person, you had children with this person, and this is what's happening, and maybe feeling that somebody else has it right now, it is like really devastating for you, and it's kind of like even maybe looking at the situation, thinking about the situation, whether this person is with somebody or they might be with somebody, it's just like a horrifying kind of like predicament. Judgment means you need to bring all this past to the surface. Princess of Cups is, you know, kind of like learning about your own emotions, learning about your own maturity. But this also can mean a love offer. This actually could, guys, mean that in your case, your twin flame might resurface. Might actually, especially if this person and you have been sort of like distant or live at a distance. I absolutely see this in this category, if nothing else, for closure, because the Judgment has that kind of like feel. There are past lives that are coming to the surface. They're like those, you know, estranged lovers that are chasing each other through the centuries, those kind of like twin flames, kind of like reuniting to say, okay, what, you know, like, let's see, like, what would happen. We kind of like have to reach this final clarity in the situation. So what is karma saying here? Oh boy, You have the Tower, and then again you have the Sword energy. An expectation, but it's reversed. So, I think it's really hard to say goodbye, guys, for you. Because right now, for you, the most important is to find the answers. The Prince of Swords is actually King of Swords. It's like that air element. It is ability to kind of like understand the truth. See, he has this little kind of falcon or eagle over here. He's carrying the book. He is seeking the knowledge. But look, he's actually very happy. He's really eager, big eyes, expectations. But look at how he's looking at this tower. It is kind of understanding that something that has happened, somebody's crown has fell down. Maybe you have placed somebody on a pedestal. Maybe this was your crown that kind of like for some reason was not there, because here it's saying you need to kind of like put it back. Maybe certain things just couldn't work out. Maybe the expectations that have been established were not possible. So for you in this period of time to find the understanding and information and asking questions, even if this is just asking it of yourself, is going to be really, really important. I absolutely see this like overwhelming healing energy. But healing energy, it's sort of like putting you back in the saddle. There is like sort of like release and restart energy that you have. And it's the energy of kind of like letting go anything toxic. But it's still going to happen something that is almost like going to validate you. It's going to validate the things that you have been going through, and it's going to kind of like reach that point of, you know, like sometimes like two people just like reach the natural kind of ending. But it doesn't have to necessarily happen. It could be just simply be clarification. Because when the tower shows, and it shows it's connecting you with all of this, it might be kind of like going through entire cycle, like few more times. It's kind of like a rinse cycle. It's kind of like wash and rinse, but in your case, it's like wash, rinse, and repeat, and repeat, and repeat. Because almost like looks to me, my dear Leo, that you're stuck, like, you know, this like old broken record, and it keeps stuck and keeps repeating the same thing. To some extent, this kind of has it, because you're still in the mood of contemplation. You're still in the mood of, look, I'm just like putting one foot in front of another. I'm paying attention to my work. You have lots of pentacle energy. Maybe there is avoidance of looking deep. Maybe it's a fear, if I go deep, I'm going to hurt. But at the same time, I do see this like willing and open energy and getting out of jail card. And this is all really, really good. So let me just get one more card for the final advice, my dear Leo. My dear Leo, advice for Leo for July for their twin flame. Leo, July advice for their twin flame. I'm getting wishing well reversed. So let's see, what is this all about? It says, desire is the sacred impulse for life. Feel it, but let go of all attachment to ownership. Yeah, I think that can kind of like describe it. So this card is reversed for you. So this is what it says. This is not a time to force anything to happen in your life, especially whatever seems to be eluding you. You can demand that the universe provide you with what you want. Unmet desires can burst into a destructive fire of obsession. And I think this is what this was talking about. Just don't get obsessed. Don't chase this truth too much, because truth is already contained within you. Step back, breathe, and take your attention away from what you want. Ask instead for what you need. Only the unseen knows how to align desire, inspiration, and its manifest form. As the coin disappears into the mystery of the dark pool at the bottom of the well, have faith. Don't engage in wishful thinking. You must co-create with spirit, not make demands. You may get what you want. Never forget that life is filled with choices. Make a wish, but be open to the enchanted way in which spirit fulfills your desire. So my dear Leo, it's going to be a lot about what you want. It's going to be a lot about if you're able to put yourself first. Because if you're not, and you're not capable of swimming, somebody else is going to drown with you. So it is kind of like rediscovering yourself. It's not going to be easy. You are traveling that road, but you like looks like reconnecting, or you're reaching some kind of like final clarity. So my dear Leo, it would be great to get your comments. And if you haven't subscribed, please do. We would like to actually see you back. And until the next time, I love you. And you can get your own twin flame reading or karma reading or past lives reading via my website, katera.ca. Love you, everybody.